Bradbury Mitchell the first. I don't get it. We brought you into the Boner Club to fight for truth and justice, not to side with corporate America. We were rock stars, baby. We did what we wanted, when we wanted, to who we wanted. But now that's all changed, hasn't it? See, what you've done is you've opened up my eyes. Instead of cheating, taking the easy way out, I should have been putting in the work. I should have been getting myself better. And I didn't do that. And because of that, it allowed you to pull the wool over my eyes. You see, the worm has turned, Niall. You see, you haven't changed. You haven't grown. You're the same person you were. The same person you'll always be. Meanwhile, I'm gonna be up earlier than you, training harder than you. And when I get my hands on you, you're gonna feel it. I used to think that you were a good brother, but you're just a bad man.
Welcome to Cohasset, Mass. Marty Magic here.
Dick McFly sitting down in the building.
Woo! We're always sitting down.
I'm just so excited, Marty Magic. We got a Hell in a Cell.
It's the first one of its kind ever in the FHB. Now, we just heard from Mitch Bitch. He seems very upset.
You know, he's got a real problem brewing with Niall Bradbury Mitchell, but he needs to get his head in the game. He's got a Hell in a Cell with the Ripper Danny B. These guys have been going at it for weeks.
That's right, and this is the last match. It'll culminate this bloodthirsty feud.
And, you know, not only is it in a cell because it's the culmination of this huge feud, but we got to keep Niall Bradbury Mitchell out of here. This feud between Justin, Mitch Bitch, and Niall Bradbury is ready to boil over. You got to get the cage. Keep him out of here.
And there's the ominous tones of the Ripper coming down to ringside to rip out the hearts of his opponent. And maybe eat them. I'm not sure.
Marty Magic, week in and week out. The Ripper Danny B and Mitch Bitch have been going back and forth, and we have yet to get a clear winner in this battle that we've seen.
It's as if God himself has created two equal men, two equal opponents, and neither one of them can get the upper hand on the other.
It was at the Royal Rumble. We thought in an Iron Man match, what other way could you possibly have to finish it off? I mean, surely we're going to have a decisive winner, and it ended in a tie. And ladies and gentlemen, let's get this thing underway. A Hell in the Cell, a first ever in the FHB.
Those are words that we don't like to use, like the H word.
Yeah, it's a bad word. And the Ripper wasting no time.
No time fucking this guy
up. Oh, and the Mitch Bitch just reverses it. He slammed his face into that cage. There's nothing more unforgiving than that cold steel
and
in that cell.
The Ripper could use a makeover if you ask me.
What a mug on that guy. He looks like Edward Scissorhands.
But, anyway. The Ripper.
I digress.
The Ripper has given it to Mitch Bitch early, taking control. There seems to be a hammer of some sort that was thrown into the ring, possibly
From the heavens.
From the heavens, that's right. Probably fell down. There's the cage up top, there's more room for something to slip down through.
Yeah, one of the hands putting this cage together earlier tonight. Oh my goodness, the bucking slam!
That's the move that finished off Mitch Bitch after four of them last time. He's going right back for that win.
Oh, going back to the well. Two, three, no! Ooh. Mitch Bitch kicks out.
Maybe he went back to the well one too many times, Dick.
I think that's exactly what he did. Marty. And he's going for the bucking slam.
A grounded bucking slam.
Right in the middle of the ring. You know. Ooh. Oh, he's going to go for that knee.
This
that
is
knee
gonna be
attack. That running knee smash.
Right to the skull.
And can he hit it? He did hit it.
Mitch Bitch is down. That's the match.
Off to a hot start. Hot start. You can tell we're from Cohasset. We got one, two. Kick out
kick
from
out,
Mitch
strong
Bitch.
Strong kick out from Mitch Bitch. He will not give up. This man, I got to tell you, a couple weeks ago, I think he would have just keeled over or, you know, maybe low-blowed the guy, hit him in the face with that hammer. Today, he's trying to fight back.
Ripper kill shot! And he tossed him straight up in the air and caught him on the way down. The Ripper is in the zone tonight.
He is dead. Eat his heart.
Oh, my God, Marty. Mitch Bitch kicked out.
There are just some things you don't expect to see in life. A baby come out of a birth canal.
Or a butthole.
A butthole.
A baby coming out of a... Oh, my God, a suplex Falcon Arrow driver. Oh, my God. And a DDT. I was going to say, is Mitch Bitch worried about Nile and not taking this thing seriously?
That's true.
But I don't know. He seems to have dialed it in. He set him up for a super kick.
And here he comes in with a little squeaky wheel.
Man, as he runs slow.
He
oh, my God. DDT.
Double-arm DDT. Driving that huge skull right into the mat.
Going for the pin, though. This could do it. We got a two.
You know, mentioned maybe his head's not in the game. The entire interview he gave earlier, he was just talking nonstop about Nile Bradbury Mitchell the First.
And you can't really blame him. The entire season, this Boner Club has been a tight-knit unit, tight-knit group.
Just like a tight,
and
you know.
In the recent weeks, the whole thing is just blowing up. And I wonder if Mitch Bitch is thinking about other things. And,
but he's got his foot on the rope.
He's got his foot on the ropes, Marty.
Are you kidding
Three?
Me?
That's it. The Ripper wins the match. He wins the battle. And did he win the war? I don't know. He used the ropes, Marty.
It's as if the Ripper decided he couldn't beat him up straight ahead. Let's start all that over. He couldn't beat him up straight ahead. What?
Yeah, give me. Shut up and give me head, Marty. But no, I know what you're saying.
Yeah.
He couldn't beat him, head on. Every week they went back and forth. There was no clear-cut winner. And he had to resort to a tactics like that.
What a son of a bitch.
I don't know how I feel about this guy. First there's murder. He's slitting the throats of all those whores. And now he's cheating. Not on the whores. He's cheating in the FHB ring.
This is why we left that goddamn country.
Absolutely.
Just like you.
He puts the cunt in country.
Well, well, well. If it isn't the elephant in the room, it's simple. Strategically, I'm not going to waste my time with Nile Bradbury Mitchell the First. I'll let Mitch Bitch handle that shit. My eye is on taking out the top dog, the longest reigning FHB champion, Guti. Not going to lie, I got a few butterflies in my stomach, but nothing a bunch of guns and hot broads can't handle. So I'll go do some training, and I'll show up at the next pay-per-view event. I'll whoop your ass. I'll take the belt. Do you want to know why? Because nobody can fucking beat me.
KESSELMANIA, the main event, the streak versus the belt, danger versus Guti. Oh yeah.
Yo, what up, Blaque Bombshell, baby? Your Northeast champion. I've been getting a lot of requests lately. Everybody wants to know why I attacked Matty Ice. Everybody wants to know why I took a steel chair and smacked it across the skull repeatedly and left him face down and bloody in the backstage area. Well, unbeknownst to the FHB universe, Matty Ice was an original member of Last Resort. Back when we wrestled in the NLW, of course we were champions. Fight after fight, championship match after the championship match, main event after main event. We were the most electrifying team that the sports entertainment has ever seen. Everybody knew who Last Resort was because of us. Then Matty, you come to FHB, somehow win the championship. You let that fame run to your head. You won't do interviews anymore. You won't send in promos. You wear your prescription glasses and your little fancy scarves. Bro, you're a hack. You're a has-been. You're washed up. You're even a sellout. Bro, without me, you wouldn't know how to lace your boots. You wouldn't know how to scrap in the squared circle. You wouldn't even know how to pick up chicks without me, bro. You will continue to fight Last Resort before you get in the ring with me. Until you prove you're worthy to get in the ring with me, bro. If you didn't like what happened to you last week, wait till you see what we got in store for you this week. Aye, homeboy.
Those are some choice words from the Blaque Bombshell to Matty Ice.
I did not realize, Marty Magic, that there was such a history between the Blaque Bombshell and Matty Ice. Now it's starting to make sense, that attack at the Royal Trumple.
Sometimes mysteries are best left unsolved. One was solved for us.
Robert Stack didn't even have to do it.
Meanwhile, what a matchup. Diamond Dave Rogers and Gorgeous Borges, a team that nobody wanted to see, put together, and they're gonna battle the Double C's for the number one contendership. The winner goes on to KESSELMANIA to fight the Dorchester Boys for the tag team title.
That's right, ladies and gentlemen, the Double C's, that's Chaos in the Crucible from Last Resort. Something's gotta give here. Is it gonna be this new tag team, or is it gonna be these guys, the Double C's? What is this new music, Marty Magic?
Oh, it sounds like some really terrible rock and roll from the late 90s. These guys,
new metal.
They probably really like it. Look at them.
Well, I did speak to the Blaque Bombshell earlier, and he reassured me, that his music stayed the same. It was the Double C's. They wanted to have their own little flavor. They wanted their own little mix coming down in the ring.
They got their own mix. It's black and white.
Michael Jackson?
Anyway, Dick, did I tell you that earlier tonight I talked to Blaque Bombshell? I asked him if he could wear a Bluetooth speaker in his ear.
What?
That's right.
Oh, I can't wait. As you can see, he's out there. He's gonna manage the Double C's here. And are you serious? We're gonna be able to talk to him?
We're gonna be able to talk to him. Hopefully he talks better to us.
The budget we have, I can't imagine we bought the best Bluetooth, but
it's about $15
from Taiwan on eBay.
Blaque Bombshell, can you hear us?
Is this thing on?
I can hear you.
Yo, right off the Blaque Bombshell, baby.
All right. We're in business, Marty. Now,
hello.
How
are you?
Can you hear me?
We got a match. We got a match. Blaque Bombshell, this is a number one contenders match for the FHB Tag Team title.
Yeah. I got my boys out here about to handle this.
Unbelievable.
Now, Blaque Bombshell, can I ask you about Chaos, this young upstart?
What's his
story?
This little boy, this is my little brother. He came out here from the projects. He's crazy.
The main streets of
him. He's insane.
Fall Rip.
Catastrophic.
Catastrophic and chaotic. I like it, Marty.
He's crazy.
Now, I can see you on the outside there. What are you seeing here?
A lot of action. I see chaos stopping the hell out of Georgie Borgie.
That's your old pal, Gorgeous
Borgie.
Absolutely.
Can't stand that guy. Yeah, knock him the hell out of the ring. That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah, the big feud that culminated in a victory for you, Blaque Bombshell. You defeated Gorgeous Borgie in a steel cage a couple months ago.
Yeah, I had to take some time out, you know, and show this little boy who's boss, this little Portuguese man of war.
And we didn't see the Gorgeous Borgie for weeks. It wasn't until Diamond Dave needed a partner.
Yeah, I sent them back to his country. He got deported.
And they were successful. Diamond Dave and Borgie had a victory last week. And now they're in line. They could be the number one contenders if they just get one more victory over your boys, the Double C's.
Listen, that's not happening. The Double C's, I trained them well. Being the founder of Last Resort, there's a lot that you got to do. Oh, you almost had it right there.
Well.
But you got to learn. You got to teach. You got to teach them, you know,
your chicklets.
Your disciples.
That's right.
Your disciples. Ah, that's a little crazy. We ain't disciples.
Okay.
The disciples of Apocalypse.
Nope.
Apocalypse is actually scared of us. Because we are that crazy. We plan on taking over this entire establishment.
Now, how are you going to go about that, Blaque Bombshell?
Well, I think the Jeffbomber might have a chance of taking out, what's that dude's name again?
Sir Fart-A-Lot.
Yeah, that cornball.
Those two hate each other.
Are you suggesting you're going to be involved in that match?
First of all, does anybody else notice that they look like each other? Or is it just me?
Well, I've noticed that Jeffbomber has much better hair, Blaque Bombshell.
Listen, the Blaque Bombshell knows when he sees, smells a fish.
And it's usually a pussy.
That's why I stay away from that shit.
And meanwhile, Chaos whipping Diamond Dave into the corner here. Chaos has been very impressive. That might be your little brother, but it's nothing little about the performance he's put on and the success he's had in the FHB thus far.
Dude, he's from the mean streets. What do you expect?
Of Greenwich?
Nah, Dorchester, baby. Where the real Dorchester boys
now
be at.
How about the other Diamond member of Last Resort?
Super.
Mr. Crucible.
Going for the pin.
Tell me about him.
Oh, kick that out. You're pissing me off, man. Get up.
What?
Get up. Chaos, stop playing around. Get in this ring.
Now, we haven't seen Enforcer in a while.
Last Resort, that's right. The Enforcer.
That dude, he's busy enforcing shit.
Gotcha.
Last we saw,
he's on a sabbatical.
He was at the Royal Trumper.
Oh, Chaos getting ready for the K-Factor.
Here it comes.
Oh, look out.
Yeah, one, two, three.
Ride that doggy.
Shove your balls up in his face. Emasculate him.
I understand that the tag team championship match will occur at KESSELMANIA. The Dorchester Boys, the FHB tag team champs, will take on the winners of this match.
Yeah!
Oh, look at that!
Finish
the 3C! 1, 2, 3!
That's what I'm talking about,
ladies and gentlemen!
Last Resort in the building!
I told you.
Nobody can take Last Resort. Absolutely, baby. Nah, I'm Blaque Bombshell, baby. Whatever I say, happens. No matter what you say or what you do, this is what I gotta say. You want the lottery numbers?
What are they?
1, 2, 3, fuck you.
The Dorchester Boys, those FHB Tag Team Champions, will take on the Double C's from Last Resort at KESSELMANIA in just 3 weeks. I can't wait to see what the Double C's, you know, I'm usually a fan of the Double D's, but these Double C's are pretty nice too, Marty.
I don't know, I mean, I gotta admit, they
didn't resort
to any
character
all day, but we've seen it in the past, they're no good
stories. Yo, I'm tired, you motherfuckers, on shit about me.
I turned back off. Blaque Bombshell, not happy. But he is happy with that victory.
I'm coming for him. Let me take the mic off me.
You know what, Sir Fart-A-Lot? I've had a lot of time to reflect on this past season. I've had a lot of time to look in the mirror. Time to look at myself. It's time to call a spade a spade. See, all my shortcomings this year I've had to find a scapegoat, find a whipping boy. Anytime I came up short, I had to find somebody to blame. And that somebody was you. You see, I didn't take responsibility for my own actions. I didn't own up to my defeats. It was just easier to blame you. But you know, somewhere along the way, I actually started doing something right. And instead of finally getting what I deserved, what I had coming to me, you're the one that went in the wrong direction. You're the one that took the wrong path, and you took it all away from me. You see, it was in this moment that I realized it's gone too far. There's no going back. You see, this entire year so far, you and I have left a trail of destruction behind us. We left a path of scorched earth beneath our feet. It's gotten to the point where you and I, our word is no better than the mud beneath my boots right now, Sir Fartalot. But we still have time. The way I see it, we still have 3 weeks. It's time to cut the crap. No more overdramatic threats. No more over-the-top descriptions of my hatred for you. Now, we only have enough time left that there might be a chance that one of us can rise from the ashes and do something right for a change. Sir Fartalot, I want you in a fight. And it's going to be the end. At this point, I don't care if it's you, if it's me, one of us has to go. This place ain't big enough for the both of us. And the only way one of us can finally start to do what's right and lead this company where it needs to go, the other one can't be there. That's right, Sir Fartle. I want you, one-on-one, eye-to-eye, loser leaves town. I'm ready to blow my brains out. I'm ready to commit career suicide, Sir Fartalot. If it's the last thing that I do, I'm gonna do something right for once.
Oh my God, dude! We've been watching that amazing Jeffbomber interview, and Diamond Dallas, Diamond Dave Rogers, he went down. And grabbed Gorgeous Borders while he was trying to leave.
They were unsuccessful in that match against the Double C's. And Diamond Dave is flipping out! That ain't right! He's taking it all out on Gorgeous Borges! He got pinned! What's going on?
He's a no-good son of a bitch! Tune in for the remaining of this episode. It's a... No.
We Now you do what they told ya. Now you do what they told ya. Now you do what they told ya. Now you do what they told ya.
Hey.